Hi students, coming to the next topic, that is the embedded software design process. So how your embedded software is going to be designed and what are the basic steps you need to take to design the software for your embedded system. So these are the different steps, totally eight. Okay, total eight steps you have to be considered while you are designing your embedded system. So the first thing is, first you need to determine the requirements. So what are the requirements you want to design a software for your embedded system? So that requirements you have to be gathered. After that, gathering the requirements, design the system architecture. So just the pictorial representation of your requirements, design the system architecture. Next, you have to select the operating system. So once the pictorial representation is ready, the graphical representation is ready, then you need to select the operating systems, on which operating system you are going to design your embedded software. Okay, so select the operating system. So after selecting the operating system, anything like Linux and or Windows or whatever it may be are selected, then choose the processor and peripherals. So what type of processor you need, what type of microcontroller you need, and what type of peripherals, the input output devices you need, so that you have to be selected. Next, choose a development platform. So in which development platform you're going to. So selecting operating system is working on that system, and choosing the development platform means is writing the code for your embedded system. So choose the development platform. After that, you have to code the application and optimize. So after selecting the language, so whatever the language, the high level language you are going to select, for that you need to write the application codes. So next, you have to verify the software on the host system and verify the software on the target system. Okay, so this is a process that completely, if you want to design the embedded software, these are the steps you have to be followed. So let me explain each and every step clearly. The first step is to determine the requirements. How you are going to determine your requirements or determine the requirements for the embedded software? So there may be a functional and non-functional requirements. So like multi-mode or multifunctional systems. So that's, think about the size, cost, weight, etc. of your requirements. And choosing the hardware components also. The requirements is not only you have to think about the software, means the size of your product like that. So you have to think about the hardware components, what you're going to be used. So like application specific hardware, external interface, I/O devices that you are using. So these are all comes under the requirements. Selecting the parts, selecting the equipments. So after determining the requirements, next step is you have to design the system architecture. The architecture of embedded system depends on whether the system is in real time. So the first thing is whether your system, whatever the embedded system you are working, that is worked on real time or not. So suppose if you are designing aircraft, some any one of the component you are going to be designed. So this aircraft is working on a real time system, real time applications. So you have to check whether it is a real time or not, whether the system you are designing is real time or not. Next, whether the operating system needs to be embedded. Next, cost, size, power consumption, so that you have to be designed. So the next I think I said, select the operating system. So real-time operating systems means RT Linux, VxWorks, PSSS, SOS, QNX. These are all the real-time operating systems. If you are not working on real-time, if it is a non-real-time operating system, then go for Windows CE, embedded Windows XP. So this Windows CE and Windows XP work on the non-real-time applications. And whereas the real-time operating systems are RT Linux, VxWorks and PSSOS, etc. Okay, I selected one of the software. If you are working on real time, I can go for any one of the. If I am working on non-real time, I can choose any one of the operating system. Next, choose the processor. What type of processor you want to work on that software? Microprocessor, maybe 8085, 8086 or Pentium. If you are choosing the microcontroller, means you have to select PIC, MCS51, 430 or AVR. Okay, if you are using digital signal processor, then you can select DSPIC, Sharp and TigerShare. So these are all the different processor and microcontroller. Based on your requirement and based on your performance of your system, you can choose any one of the controllers. Next, choose the development platform. So what type of platform you are going to be work. like hardware platform, programming language, operating system, development tools that you have to be choose. Okay, after choosing the development platform, next step is next design step is code the application and optimize. How you are going to code the applications and how you are going to optimize that. The coding of an embedded system can be done by using any of these following programming languages. You can take assembly language. Okay, if you are using the microcontrollers, then go for the assembly language. Suppose if you are using the C language, okay, C language, object-oriented languages like C++, Java, or optimizing the code. So next is verify the software on the host system. So you have to first you need to verify the software on your system. Next you have to be verify on the target system. So while you are verifying the software on the host system means compile and assemble the source code into object file. So whatever the program you have written in high level language, that you should be compiled. After that you need to assemble the source code that should be converted into object files like zeros and ones. So use a simulator to simulate the working of the system. So that is the conditions you have to be take care while you are verifying the software in your host system. So the finally, you have to verify the software on target system. So in target system, first you need to download the program using a programmer device and use emulator or on-chip debugging tools to verify the software. So these are all the different design process. This is a embedded software design process. Embedded software design process. First you need to determine the requirements, next design the architecture, select operating system, choose the processor and peripherals, and after that you need to select the development platform and code the applications. After implement the application, then you need to verify the software on host system, next target system. Thank you.